What is up, guys? It is Nathan. I am so excited to see you guys at Kids Church. I haven't been here in a minute. All the leaders have been doing such an awesome job saying hi to you. But I just wanted to say that I love you and I miss you so, so much. I cannot wait to see you guys, but we will be doing that at our next drive-through on the 27th of September. So make sure you ask your parents to be there. Kids Church has been a blast. I hope you guys are doing it with your families, learning about Jesus together. So on the topic of Kids Church, let's jump right into today's video. See you guys on the other side.
Hi families, are you ready to go on a Bible adventure? Me too! But before we see Emily and Shine, we're gonna do prop talk! Are you guys excited? Yay! Okay, let's see what I have today. What is this? That's right, it's a giant pencil! Friends, what can I do with a pencil? I can write! Okay, I think I'm gonna write really big with my giant pencil. I'm gonna draw a heart. Can you guys draw one in the air with me? Awesome! Okay, let's do it. I drew a heart. Did you guys draw one too? Oh, I bet they're beautiful. Well, friends, what else does my pencil have? What's this thing? You guys are so smart. It's an eraser. An eraser can erase my heart. I'm gonna erase mine. Can you do it too? Friends, this eraser reminds me of Jesus because Jesus erases our sins. Our sins are wrong choices that we make. Can you guys give me some examples of wrong choices we sometimes make? Oh yeah, like not sharing our toys or not listening to our parents and leaders. Or throwing a tantrum when we don't get our way? Ugh, those are all wrong choices, right? Yeah, how do those wrong choices make our hearts feel? Yucky, right? Can you guys put your hands on your heart and show me a sad face? Those are some sad faces, you guys. I think we should ask Jesus to forgive our sins. Can you guys do it with me? Jesus, please forgive my sins. Great job, friends. All right, can you smile and say thank you, Jesus? Great job. Are you guys ready to go on our Bible adventure? Shake your hands high in the sky. Let's go.
On your mark, get set, go on a Bible adventure. So much in the Bible for me to know on my Bible adventure. I want to know that God is real. I want to know how I could be his friend. I want to know who Jesus is. I want to find out what the Bible's all about. Hey! Do-do-do-do. Do-do-do-do. Do-do-do. La-la-la-la. La-la-la-la. La-la-la. On your mark, get set, go on a Bible adventure. So many ways that I will grow on my Bible adventure. I'm gonna learn my memory verse. I'm gonna pray and talk to God. I'm gonna sing new songs to God and keep singing the songs all week long. Oh, do 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 do. Do 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 do. Do do do. La 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 la. La 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 la. La la la. On your mark, get set, go on a Bible adventure. Church is a fun place we can go on a Bible adventure.
Glittering glow bugs! I just got a message from Shine! How can I be God's friend? I'm going on a Bible adventure to find out. Shake your hands high in the sky if you want to go with me. Woohoo!
Hello? Hello? Emily, do you want to go on a Bible adventure?
I do want to go! Friends, who do you think would be inviting me to go on a Bible adventure? Let's see if you're right. Come in. Dollars and donuts. It is Shine. Let's get going.
Wait, Emily, we can't go yet.
Oh, yeah. I have to pack my adventure bag. Shine, will you help us figure out which picture passes will tell us how we can be God's friend?
Yes, we'll all work together. Put on your adventure bags. The first picture pass is something made out of wood. It looks like the letter T.
Do you know which one it is, friends? My friends say it's the cross!
Good job, friends! It is the cross! Open up your adventure bags!
The cross is in my adventure bag! What's next?
Think about writing your name with a pencil. When you make a mistake, what will you use to fix it?
Something to fix my mistake.
It's pink, too.
Oh, I think I know what it is! What do you think it is?
It's an eraser! Put the eraser in your adventure bag.
What's the last picture pass? I have room for one more.
It's sticky.
Sticky? Like a sticker?
Yes, and it helps your ouchies get better. Friends, do you know what I'm talking about?
Great job! It is the bandage! The bandage is in my adventure bag. Let's zip our adventure bags together.
Now it's time to fly.
Here we go. A cross, an eraser, a bandage. How do these things make me friends with God?
They won't make you God's friend, but they'll help you remember somebody who will.
Wait, somebody makes me God's friend?
Yes, somebody very special. Somebody who is the Son of God. Friends, do you know his name?
It's Jesus! But how does Jesus make me friends with God?
I'm glad you asked. The answer is in the Bible.
The Bible is God's book for you. You can trust. It's right and true. Oh!
A happy Sunday. Since it's a story about Jesus, you can find it in the books of Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John.
Those are the four books of the Bible that tell us all about his life here on earth. Will it answer the question, how can I be God's friend?
Let's watch it and find out.
Sunday morning, some women went to put burial spices on Jesus' body. They knew a big stone was covering the tomb's entrance and wondered how they would move it. When they arrived, the stone had already been moved. Jesus' body was gone, and there were angels in the tomb. "Jesus is alive," the angel said. "Go tell his disciples." The women told the disciples, and Peter and John ran to Jesus' tomb to see for themselves. All they found were Jesus' burial cloths. They went back home, confused. Later, the disciples were gathered together in a room. They were talking about what had happened when Jesus appeared to them. They were terrified. They thought he was a ghost. "Don't worry," said Jesus. "See my hands and feet? It's me. Touch me. Go on. You can't touch a ghost, and ghosts don't eat either, but I'm feeling really hungry." So he ate some fish. Then he taught them. "The scriptures are clear," he said. "The Messiah was supposed to suffer and die, and then be raised from the dead. Now tell the world what you have seen. Let everyone know that their sins can be forgiven if they turn to God. It's possible because of what I have done."
Bloom and blossoms! Jesus was dead, and now he's alive again!
That's right, Emily. Jesus rose from the dead to make us all friends with God.
Jesus did that so we could be friends with God? I still have a lot to learn.
No worries, Emily. Just remember the Bible story and your picture passes.
Oh, yeah, the picture passes. Say them with me, friends. A cross, a bandage, an eraser. Help me remember them as we try to find the answer to the question, how can I be God's friend?
And I'll see if Blinky knows how he can be God's friend. See ya!
Bye, Shine!
Oh! I wonder who that could be. I'm expecting Emily. Think it's her? Come in! It is Emily! Hi, Emily!
Hi, Guy!
Good to see you. What's up?
Well, I want to know the answer to the question, how can I be God's friend?
I was just reading that story in the Bible.
We were too! Friends, tell Guy who died but came alive again!
You know what you're talking about. Jesus makes me God's friend because I believe he lives again.
Leaping lily pads! That's the answer! Jesus makes me God's friend because I believe he lives again!
Jesus made a way for us to be friends with God when he died on the cross for all our sins.
That reminds me of one of our picture passes. Which one is made out of wood and looks like the letter T? Sweet sassy molassie! It is the cross!
All of the sins of the world had to have a big punishment. Jesus took the punishment for all our sins when he was hung up on a big wooden cross and died.
Oh, that sounds so sad.
It was sad, but it's wonderful at the same time. Jesus made a way for us to be friends with God forever.
Wow! I am friends with God. I told Jesus that I believe he died on the cross and that he came to life again. Then I asked him to forgive me for all my wrong choices. I let Jesus be the boss of everything I do. And I tell others about him all the time. I am a friend of God.
There are a lot of verses in the Bible about all of those things. But I have a very special one for you today. Wiggle your ears if you want to learn it with me, friends. Okay, watch this. Romans 10:9. Believe in your heart, bum, 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 that God raised him from the dead. Woo!
Oh, mama's pajamas, that was fun. I want to learn it too.
Okay, repeat after me.
Okay.
Romans 10:9.
Romans 10:9.
Believe in your heart, bum, 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 bum.
Believe in your heart, bum, 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 bum.
That God. Raised him from the dead. Woo-hoo!
Raised him from the dead. Woo-hoo! Okay, I got it. Let's do it again.
Okay. All together now.
Romans 10:9. Believe in your heart. Bum, 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 bum.
That God
raised him from the dead. Woo-hoo!
Fantastic!
I do believe in my heart that Jesus is alive!
That's what I like to hear. Now don't forget, how can I be God's friend?
Jesus makes me God's friend because I believe he lives again!
Yeah.
Jesus forgives me and he's the boss of my life.
Mm-hmm.
Cool. Bye, Guy.
Bye, Emily.
Come on.
Bye, friends. Ooh.
I'm looking for my friend, Blinky. Can you see him anywhere? Blinky! Blinky! Where are you? Friends, do you see that glow bag yet? You do see him? Is he in the sky? No? Wait, where? Say it again, friends. Behind a rock? Why would Blinky hide behind a little rock? Oh my! He is there! Blinky, come out! We're here to play!
Oh, I just can't. I don't want anyone to see me ever again.
I need your help. I'll count 1, 2, 3. Then we'll all say, come out, Blinky! Okay, ready? 1, 2, 3. Come out, Blinky!
Are you sure you want me to come out, friends? Okay, if you really want me to.
Oh, Blinky, you are sad.
Well, I know. I just don't think anyone will ever want to be friends with me. I did a bad thing, and I'm embarrassed. I should go back behind that rock.
No, Blinky. We always want to be friends with you.
But you don't know what I did. I got mad and threw a fit. I yelled at my teacher at church. And everybody was staring at me, everybody. They're all gonna think I'm a bad bug.
You did make some very wrong choices, but we all still want to be friends with you.
What? Why would you want to be friends with me after I did such a bad thing?
Why do we still want to be friends with Blinky after he made a wrong choice? We want to be friends with you because God wants to be friends with you.
Well, how could God want to be my friend after I threw such a horrible fit?
Blinky, God always loves you no matter what. That's what grace means. He keeps on loving us even though we don't deserve it. Live like you believe Jesus died for your sins on the cross. Remember, he came back to life. Jesus made a way for everyone to be friends with God.
I do believe it, Shine. Jesus is my leader, and I want to live just like him and quit throwing fits.
Then why did you get so sad? You are God's friend. That's a big deal. God will never stop being your friend.
Whew! I'm so happy to hear that. I'm glad God has lots of grace to love all of us, even when we act naughty. I'm gonna try again. No more hiding behind rocks.
That's great, Blinky. Now that you feel better, let's play.
Yes, I'm ready to have some fun.
Tag, you're it.
How can I be God's friend? Will you answer with me? Jesus makes me God's friend because I believe he lives again. Great job! You know, Jesus did such a great thing for us. It wasn't easy for him to die on the cross. He had to be nailed to that wooden cross. That means they put real nails in his hands with a big hammer, and it hurt him so much. But Jesus wants you and me to be friends with God, so he did it anyway. Wow, Jesus must really love us. But what about the other two picture passes? A bandage, an eraser. I hope Mr. Music will be able to teach us about one of these today. Come on, let's go find out.
A knock? Who is it?
It's me, Emily.
Well, come on in, Emily.
Hi, Mr. Music. My friends and I were just coming to ask you a question about Jesus.
Jesus? He's who I sing my songs to.
Yeah, but dying on the cross was so hard, and it hurt him so much. Why did Jesus do that?
It's because of grace.
Grace? What does that mean?
Grace means God loves you, even when you choose to sin, even though you don't deserve it.
God always loves me? And he always wants to be my friend?
Yes. Always. But God can't be friends with sin and wrong choices.
Oh no, I've made wrong choices.
That's why God gives us grace. God sent Jesus to die on the cross to take the punishment for all our wrong choices.
Jesus was punished for my wrong choices? But Jesus never did anything wrong. He never even sinned once. He didn't deserve that.
No, he didn't. But Jesus loves us so much, he did it anyway. Is he the leader of your life? Do you believe he died and came back to life again?
Yes! Romans 10:9. Believe in your heart, boom, 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 that God raised him from the dead. Woohoo!
Then you're God's friend. When you make a wrong choice, ask God to forgive you. Jesus will erase that sin.
Erase! Like an eraser! Grace means that Jesus died on the cross to erase all of our wrong choices. Now I can be God's friend because I believe he lives again.
You know, that reminds me of a song.
We want to hear it. Clap your hands together with me, friends, so Mr. Music will play us a song.
Okay, I'll play it.
Jesus is alive. Jesus is alive in me. Jesus is my friend. Jesus is the friend I need.
Ready?
Here we go.
Repeat after me.
Okay.
I believe in Jesus.
I believe in Jesus.
I believe he's alive.
I believe he's alive.
I believe in Jesus.
I believe in Jesus.
I believe he's alive.
I believe he's alive.
That was great.
Yeah, let's do it again.
Okay.
Jesus rose again. Jesus rose up from the dead. Jesus is the way. Jesus is the way to be God's friend.
Ready?
Here we go.
Okay.
I believe in Jesus.
I believe in Jesus.
I believe he's alive.
I believe he's alive.
I believe in Jesus.
I believe in Jesus.
I believe he's alive.
I believe he's alive.
I believe. I believe in Jesus. I believe.
About God's grace. Let's sing some more songs to thank God for being our friend.
Yeah!
Father God, I am yours. Every day I will say, Father God, I am yours. I am a child of God. When I am sad, you make me smile when I am mad. Every day you make me glad. I am a child of God. Father God, I am yours. Every day I will say, Father God, I am yours. I am a child of God. Cheer me up when I am sad, you make me smile when I am. You make me glad. I am a child of God. You cheer me up when I am sad. You make me smile when I am mad. Every day you make me glad. I am a child of God. I am a child of God. I am a child of God.
You have made me glad. You have made me glad. made me glad.
Jesus, I love you. Jesus, you love me. Jesus, I love you. Oh, and you love me.
Now dance!
Hi, Emily. So, what did you learn on your Bible adventure?
We learned that Jesus died on the cross and lives again. Romans 10:9. Believe in your heart, boom, 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 that God raised him from the dead. Woohoo! And Jesus erases our mistakes so we can be friends with God. But I'm not sure about the last picture pass.
Oh, the bandage. It shows what Jesus does for our hearts.
What do you mean?
When you make a wrong choice, it makes your heart all broken inside. But Jesus is like a band-aid for your heart. He erases your wrong choice, then makes your heart all better again.
And he makes me God's friend. I'm so glad that Jesus lives again and forgives all our mistakes, so my heart can be all better.
Did you find out the answer to the question, how can I be God's friend?
Yes, we did. Let's say it together, friends. Jesus makes me God's friend because I believe he lives again. Wow, my heart does feel better. Let's pray for our friends so Jesus can heal their hearts too.
Bow your heads and close your eyes. We're going to talk to God together.
God, thank you for giving us grace by sending your son Jesus to take the punishment for all our sins. God, I want each and every one of our friends to believe in their heart that Jesus died and rose again and make Jesus their leader. I pray that they'll all be friends with you. In Jesus' name, amen. Boggle my goggle! It's time to go! We'll see you next time!
For another Bible adventure.
Bye-bye! Friends, did you have so much fun on our Bible adventure?
Me too! I had so much fun with Emily and Shine. Do you guys know what time it is now?
It's picture passes! What is this?
You're right, it's my adventure bag. You guys put yours on with me. Are you guys ready? 1, 2, 3, whoosh! Great job, friends! All right, what do you guys think is in here? My picture passes! You guys are so smart. I wonder which one I'll pick first. Are you guys ready? Okay. What is this? Great guess! It's our eraser! The eraser reminds us that Jesus can erase sins. So friends, I have a question for you. When you ask Jesus to forgive you, what does he erase from your heart? You're right, he erases sin and wrong choices. All right, friends, let's see which picture pass I pick next. Okay, I wonder which one it'll be. What is this? You're right, it's a Band-Aid. Now, friends, I have a question. What does Jesus do to make your heart all better? Great job, friends. He makes us friends with God. His grace is like a Band-Aid for our hearts. Okay, friends, I have one more picture pass. Can you guys guess what it is? I can't hear you. Okay, let's see if you're right. What is this? You're right, it's the cross. Why did Jesus die on the cross? Because he loves us. And when he died on the cross, it helped us become friends with God. All right, friends, I had so much fun going on a Bible adventure with you. Did you have fun? Yay! There will be some questions on screen you can talk about with your families. I hope you have a great week. I'll see you later.
Hey guys, wasn't Kids Church an absolute blast? I know, right? Learning about Jesus is so much fun. And I want to encourage you guys, make sure that in the week you are reading your Bible and praying and talking to Jesus. It is the most important thing that you could ever do in your whole entire life. So that is it from me and the Kids Church team. Next week, Edgar is going to say hi to you guys. So make sure you tune in next week. We cannot wait to see you. We love you. Goodbye.